All good things start with Bismillah. Hello everybody. Today we have chapter 4, teaching language as communication among people from your textbook, teaching English as a foreign or a second language. Wish you good time, my student, for the morning and evening studies, second class. So anybody can learn a language but cannot teach it, because teaching is type of an art and teacher is an artist. If you want to be a good teacher, you should be a good artist. In this lecture, I put a heavy emphasis on the word communication. We talk to this word and to explain many points of view according the ideas of the communication among people. Now at least one foreign language has become almost necessity. However, learning a foreign language communication definitely plays a crucial role. Moreover, without communication, there is no interaction. So the idea of communication is put on the interaction. So how to make interaction between our students as a teacher. Language teaching and learning. Communication is considered as a very important, and more it is used as a useful tool to organize people-centered lessons. The idea of communication is the exchange of ideas, information, etc. between two or more persons. In the act of communication, there is usually at least one speaker, the sender, for sending the message, which is transmitted, and the person or persons for whom this message is intended, the receiver. In this lecture, we will try to put the following questions in order to find a suitable or convenient answers. Question number one, what is the main goal of a communicative classroom? Also, I'll show the picture, the number of the page. Two, how do English foreign language, English second language teachers provide opportunities for students to communicate in English? Number three, what makes a communicative classroom communicative? Also, we have on page 68. Number four, what roles related to creating a meaningful interactions? It means how to achieve the interaction inside the classroom. Question number five and the last one, what problems do some English foreign language, English second language teachers face when teaching English as a communication among people? Shall we get started? Okay. Now, we will talk about some of the highlighted points, but not all. First, you need to shed light on the concept of a communicative competence. Communicative competence includes development of a student's ability to comprehend, this is the phase number one, and to produce written and spoken English in a communicatively proficient and accurate way. The communicative competence means the knowledge on the part of the student about some of the materials he studied in the previous stage of his learning, his or her learning. Communicative competence include, number one, grammatical competence, also it's called formal competence, that is, knowledge of the grammar, vocabulary, phonology, and semantics of a language. B, sociolinguistic competence, also it is called sociocultural competence, that is the knowledge of the relationship between language and non-linguistic context, knowing how to use and respond appropriately to different types of speech act, for example, requests, apologize, thanks, etc. Knowing which address form should be used with the different persons, one speakers, and in different situations. C, discourse competence, that is knowing how to begin and end conversation. D, strategic competence, the knowledge of communication strategies that can competencies of focus on the other's area. Now, we will shift focus on the question number five to talk about one of the problems that face teachers in teaching English, whether it is a foreign or a second language. One of the above problems is the overly anxious problem. University students in their academic may therefore be suffering from various types and levels of social or general anxiety. Language anxiety is the overall feeling of worry, fear, and negativity associated with a learned foreign language. And it's therefore often considered to be situation-specific anxiety, where anxiety is experienced during language learning or communication. Anxiety means the subjective feeling of tension, nervousness, and worry associated with an arousal of the automatic nervous system. Okay, so anxiety, it is considered one of the adverse problem that face students when we talk or when he or she communicate within the classroom. So it is also considered as a state of fear. So we can explain this word, and we can put also a solution on the part of the teacher to create a meaningful understanding and to create interaction between him or her students. Number one, one of the best solutions to the anxiety is sitting within the classroom, where the student most engaged in the class activities and least engaged with the rowdy classmates. So we can put the places that they can communicate and interact with other persons. Two, following directions. Have written directions on the board or elsewhere so they are clear and visible to all. When I give instructions on the board and I put it on the board so the student can think about the possible answers. A class participation. Know the student's strength with responding. Do their better with yes or no questions, short questions, or with opinion questions. Create, on the part of the teacher, create a signal to let the student know his or her turn is coming and to provide opportunity for the student to share knowledge on the area where their student is confident. Answering the questions at the board, so the student can walk, thus break the dullness of the student. Can the student be sent from this activity, or there is another way for them to be involved? Simply writing the information on the board and then sitting down before the material is analyzed. Testing condition. Also, we have safe person, cool down pass, and large group activities. So I'll explain the change in the routine. Let the child or the student family have know of any major change in routine in order to process its change. This is the role of the family here inside the classroom that make the learning process. It is also useful for the student to know the teacher will be returning to the classroom. Using the drills. Social stories about fire drills, sometimes accompanied by the audio tape or the sound played quietly, can help the student understand what will happen when a drill occurs. Especially when we're using M3, we can catch the attention of our students. Homework expectation. Give the class an estimate of how much time each homework assignment will take. Assign every other math problems, readers' reading and writing assignments, allow books on tape, and allow alternative method for answering their written responses. That's what we have solutions for this problem. At the end of this lecture, on your textbook, you may find all the solutions to above questions. Try to answer it in a precise way. These will be your assignment. Thanks for joining me.